Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today's review is about the Corvette ZR1. This car is available through the multiplayer rewards and it is a pretty decent car, and I will be testing it today in the Platinum League. This car has good acceleration, decent handling and amazing nitro. The top speed is not that great, but it reaches there quick. So we shall see now how this car performs against all of the classes, B and A most probably, in the Platinum League. The reason I am testing it in Platinum League is because Legend League is dead. I'm just getting one-on-one and it's not worth it. The point gain is also not that much. So I will play this car in Platinum Series and let's see. Currently I have maxed the acceleration. Since that is the most important part, I think it is in multiplayer. Rest of the things, I don't think any epics, or maybe like one epic on Nitro, that's it. So let's see now. So I will also give you tips as to how to handle with this car. The reason is it has good acceleration, so I will rely on that. It is above average. I'm considering average to be around 80. So this car can go ahead of the others at the start. So we shall see where we land in the six fuels. I will not move for Legend League, of course, because I don't want to. However, we will enjoy the Platinum League grind. So the reason I play like this is because if you stay between position 2000 and about 150, then you get full lobbies. The moment you go beyond that, you get just 1v1 or something like that. So it's not worth it. As you can see, I'm just using orange nitro everywhere. And there we go. Still I can catch up. These Huracans, man. Drift and Shockwave gang. I don't think I can catch up after that KD. Let's see. Great. Man. Sad. F race. Last. Good start to that. Fast steps. Always dirty. Don't know why they play dirty that much. But it's fine. First race started with an F. Great. And Osaka again. I'm not sure where the strength of this car lies. It makes just average times everywhere. It's not out of the blue good, it's not bad. But it cannot be considered as a good car. You know, it's an average car, it's a good to have. It's not a must-have car. So if you don't have this car at max, don't sweat, because it's pretty useless if you look at it that way. If a Pagani or Aperta or 918 are driven properly, this car has no match for them, because I compared the times and about 2 seconds of difference. You cannot catch that up. So far, so good. Nice air. Wow, these guys disappeared. They drifted there. Let's see though how much time it makes on this track. Must be about say 110. Oh, I was close. 109.8. So if you compare this time 109.8, Vanda makes 106. So this car is nowhere close to that. Again a top speed track. However, I will try my best to get further away from this gang. The good thing about cars with more than 81 or 82 acceleration is that if you press double nitro at start, it gives you a considerable boost. Drift gang, drift and shockwave, yeah boy. Man. Look at this guy. He has an Evo and he is doing drift and shockwave. Let's see if I can catch up that Pagani. So to put it into perspective, the nitro speed of this car is equal to Pagani's speed without nitro. So I don't think I can catch up to him, but let me see. Unless and until he really screws it up, I don't think so. Nope. See, 368, not gonna do anything with that speed. But still some point gain. So in this multiplayer series, I know that the epic rewards are like 70,000. You need to grind a lot for that. I'm not sure if it is worth it, but I'll try my best to do that. Imagine going up to 70,000 and you get a Targa epic or NSX epic. That's not really something I would like. Go ahead. Now with higher top speed cars, you can do a wall ride over here, that's better. Whoa, F, bad physics. F race, no point. Yeah, sometimes it happens. Some races, no matter what you do, you are meant to lose. 1F after the other. See someone disconnected because it's not worth it to play 4 players or you know 3 players. Usually I also disconnect unless and until I get more players. If you want maximum rewards, you need a 8 player lobby over here. It's just like Rush, but it's reverse. In Rush we climb the leaderboards with our score. Over here you go for rewards. That's the only thing. I think there is an Evo behind me, trying desperately to catch me. You can use this route if you have some nitro left, that's a little faster than the other route. Yes, that was an Evo behind me. But such cases are rare. Probably that Evo guy was a touch driver, or maybe he was drifting a lot. But if you have an Evo, you really can't beat Evo with this car, if it is driven properly. Now, if you want to compare this car with the SV, then SV is much better than this car because of its top speed and nitro. SV is a very good overall car. This one, it is okay. It lies somewhere in the middle, but for this rank, I think if I have to rate the cars which I had in this rank, I would rank SV as number one, then probably this car, then the F12, and then the 812. The 812, I don't know, it has good handling, but everything else, it just lacks. Why physics? Just saved. Otherwise, I would have got a KD from that guy. I want to see who that guy is. Oh, Jay. Mistake. What happened? Oh, close race, DJ Ali. Very close race. However, if you compare the time, it's still 2 seconds slower than the Vanda. So, well, you have it there. If you want to win races easily, this is not the car to do that. However, it's an okay car to have in your garage. Don't sweat if you don't have it at max, or you are struggling to get the blueprints for this. It's an okay car overall. It is, I mean, if you are comparing it with GS, this is better than GS because of its speed. But other than that, this car is okay. I hope you all enjoyed this video. I hope you all subscribe to my channel if you like it. I will do a live stream every Sunday. So hope to see you all there. Bye-bye.